Nick Hawkins outside the London Stadium, West Ham Fan TV. I'm here with Freddie from the Ugly Inside. I spoke to him on Skype, you see. Fred, I'll be honest, mate, you're the worst person I want to see right now, the last person I want to see. Have you ever seen a worse team than West Ham?
This season, no. To put it quite bluntly, I mean, you're down there with Sunderland right now, aren't you? I mean, Sunderland haven't won a game, but you've got 3 points on the board, but I don't know what's going on with you boys at the moment. You look fragile, and we took advantage today.
I thought you played a very good game today. You soaked up the pressure. We wasn't really pressing anything, but we were sort of controlling the play at the beginning. But side to side, and then it was only a matter of time. I could see that. It was only a matter of time before you broke.
Yeah, we were very patient in the first half. You know, it took us 40 minutes to actually get that clinical sort of chance in the final ball, really. I mean, it was a great finish by Austin. Bit of a scuff, really, from where I saw it.
His knees do work, are you?
They do work. I mean, I don't know what David Gull's gone on about 12 months ago, but he's a superstar for us right now. He scored 5 goals in 4 games. That's 4 clean sheets for us in as many games, and we're rocking.
Listen, you're on a good run of form at the minute. Where do you see West Ham going?
You know,
honestly, be honest. Honestly, don't worry about them.
Relegation.
Yeah, I agree.
Relegation coming. So why? Too many new faces, new stadium, and West Ham is about the fans. It was all about the West Ham fans, and that isn't got the atmosphere here. We was the 11th man. West Ham have been shit since I was a kid. 4-4, 10-0, we lose fucking 4-3, 2-0 up. West Ham have always been the same. Great expectations expected West Ham this season. We're not Man United, we're not Liverpool, we're not Chelsea, we're West Ham United. And no one understands that. They'll come a new stadium, new great, fearful that we'll get relegated next season. They'll win the pub in the club. They're not West Ham supporters like Sullivan and Gold. It's a business for them. We got relegated on £100 million. They went for the playoffs, dangerous game. Got the £90 million, sold it, come to Stratford, free tickets, free this, that, the other. But like last season, if they smash the coach at Man United up, they'll kick us out just like Coventry or Wimbledon, then West Ham will disappear. And we'll spring up in about 10 years' time, then Chad Relief. And we'll,
start again.
It's got to change this. We're going to call East London United. Something's going to be a big change here. You know what I mean? It's a big change here. They really took the castle away from us. They fired a shot and no one's actually turned around and fought for that. And we've all just turned around and said, Joe, what?
And one more thing, the people standing on the back of the stadium on the top and they're watching through the cameras and they're filming. They say to the other one, they take this one, take this one.
Listen, West Ham done a study last season,
like
right? They had a million fans. So if you're looking loose, 38,000 lunatics from Upton Park will go around singing what we sing. They don't want that in the Champions League on a Tuesday night, singing what we sing. So what they do is, right, move the stadium, move the fans, segregate everybody. You can lose 38,000 because 16,000 waiting. This. They don't want us. It's like Birmingham, they want the kids and the families in here. They want to lose the old brand of West Ham United because it's associated with hooliganism. If you East London, Stratford, and they'll sell us just like they'll sell Man City, and the real supporters will go down to Chapel Leaf. That's exactly what happened. It would take 10, 15 years when I'm an old boy, and there's no one there to retaliate against it. Sorry for getting involved
in the conversation, but I'll see you in the next 10 years
where we're going. They're here to sell us. Karen Brady. Stick to your dildos, girl, because I tell you what,
she'll love that. Anyway, Fred, as I was saying, mate, sorry about that. Where are we going this season? Where do you think West Ham are going?
Well, like we just said to this mate over here that's interrupted us, I think there's a fear that West Ham is going to lose their identity. And the way that, if it's going to continue like this, you're going to be down there relegation today, you know, for the rest of the season. Bilic needs to do something quick. Because you're a team that's got potential to be top half. You finished 7th in the league last season in Europa League places.
Mate, I think we're going down. Yeah. Personally, I know it's a bit early, but I can't see any fight. This echoes 2003. We had a good squad then and we went down and we come straight back up. If we go down this time, we're not coming back.
Yeah, like you know, there is a fear that you could be the next sort of Newcastle. No team is too big to go down. You know, you've got a huge stadium. Newcastle's got a huge stadium. One of the best fan bases in the country as well, West Ham. And, you know, like I said, Bilic needs to do something quick. You know, something needs to change in the fans as well because, you know, like mate said, you know, there's no identity left in the fans anymore. The guys behind the scene want to change that and that's not what West Ham is really, is it?
Let's talk about Southampton, mate. I bet you're over the moon today. It's going to kick on your season, isn't it? You're going to be up there or up there again this season.
Over the moon, mate. 3-0 victory away from home at West Ham. You know, 4 games, 4 clean sheets, a bag of goals. You know, Austin's on fire. We're absolutely rocking now. Our confidence is sky high, despite a sticky start to the season. As we were saying on our preview the other day, but you know, these matches have now kind of kicked on to our season. It's unfortunate for you guys as well because you're in that sort of bracket where we are. You need that one game to kind of kick on your season. And luckily for us, we beat Swansea last week, and that's kicked on for these four wins in a row.
Well, good luck to you, mate, honestly. Good luck for the rest of the season. I hope we're playing again next year.